It's AumSum time.
Hi guys. Can you guess the title of my next video? Hurry up. Write your guess in the comment section below. Why do snakes shed their skin?
Wait, I'll explain. When a snake grows, its outer skin layer called epidermis does not grow or get bigger with it. Hence, the snake sheds its epidermis periodically to allow further growth of its body. In addition to this, shedding also helps remove parasites present on the epidermis.
So does the snake buy a new skin?
No. First, listen. Before shedding, the snake grows a new epidermis beneath the old one and secretes a fluid between the old and new epidermis. This fluid helps separate the old epidermis from the new one. Once this is done, the process of shedding begins. To remove the old epidermis, the snake rubs its head against any hard surface, creating a tear either near mouth or near nose area. Then, it drags and wriggles its body against any hard surface and slowly slithers out of the old epidermis. How do bees make honey?
No idea.
To make honey, the worker honeybee sucks nectar from flowers and stores it in its honey stomach. Once the worker bee returns to the hive, it vomits the nectar into a processor honeybee's mouth.
Ew!
In the processor bee's mouth and stomach, an enzyme called invertase is added to the nectar. Invertase breaks some nectar into simple sugars like glucose and fructose. Then it vomits the partially converted nectar into another processor bee's mouth, who also adds more invertase, helping break down more nectar. This process goes on until most of the nectar is converted into simple sugars. Then, the mixture of simple sugars is stored in the honeycomb. At this point, the mixture is still watery. Hence, the bees flap their wings, which evaporates water and thickens the mixture to eventually form honey. Why is salt added to icy roads?
To make ice tasty!
Nah. Salt helps melt the ice and thus clear the roads.
What? But how, dude?
The freezing or melting point of water is about 0 degrees Celsius or 32 degrees Fahrenheit. When temperature drops below the melting point, water molecules bond together to form solid ice. However, when temperature rises above the melting point, the bonds break and the ice melts, forming liquid water. Now, when we add salt or sodium chloride to ice, it lowers the melting point, causing solid ice to melt and form liquid even at temperatures below 0 degrees Celsius. Then, the salt dissociates in the liquid water, forming sodium and chloride ions. These ions make it harder for liquid water molecules to again bond together and form ice. Hence, the melting ice does not refreeze and thus helps clear the roads. Why do we have seasons?
Because of season fairies.
No. It is mainly because of our Earth's axis. Our Earth's axis is tilted at an angle of about 23.5 degrees. Hence, as the Earth revolves around the sun, sometimes the northern hemisphere points towards the sun, while sometimes the southern hemisphere. This causes seasons.
Oh man. It is too complicated.
All right, let us observe the Northern Hemisphere to learn more about seasons. When the Northern Hemisphere points towards the sun rays directly strike the Northern Hemisphere. Thus, the temperatures are high, resulting in summer season in that region. However, when the Northern Hemisphere points away from the sun rays fall slanting on it. Thus, the temperatures are low, resulting in winter season. But when the Northern Hemisphere is neither tilted towards nor away from the sun, the temperatures are moderate, resulting in spring and autumn season. Topic: transpiration. Why do cacti have spines?
Maybe they want to look like porcupines.
Very funny. Spines help cacti to reduce transpiration.
Well, I know all about vibration, but what's with this new thing called transpiration?
Transpiration is the loss of water from aerial parts, like stems and leaves, in the form of water vapor. These aerial parts contain stomata which allow water vapor to escape into the atmosphere.
So, shall we tape the aerial parts so that the vapor won't escape?
Oh, pay attention. In deserts, where cactus usually grows, there is scarcity of water. Also, due to high temperatures, the rate of transpiration is very high.
Huh?
Oh.
Thus, the leaves of a cactus have modified into spines. Spines don't have stomata. Thus, the rate of transpiration is reduced, helping the cactus to save water.